smoke
medical
weed every day.
The following thoughts on Hoffy Hour represent Brian Hoffy and Facet. Listener discretion is advised.
Live from Tampa Bay, you are tuned in to Hoppy Hour.
He's the voice of a generation that got screwed by the baby boomers. Welcome back to Hoppy Hour.
Hoppy Hour. Hoppy Hour. Hoppy Hour starts in 4, 3, 2, Hoppy. Hoppy, Hoppy. This is Hoppy Hour with Hoppy.
What up, Pharaoh?
What up, man? How you doing?
You like this intro? I was thinking about how the hell to introduce the fact that I have Pharaoh as the co-host for the podcast today. I was like, why not play this weird-ass song?
I think it's pretty amazing. I think it's new. It's refreshing. It kind of brings me back to the 90s. I feel like I'm in a Teletubbies kind of environment.
Yeah, like you're in like third grade or whatever, and you're just like, you know what?
Why not?
Dude. So what do you do? I'm going to tell everybody that my podcast is a mix of celebrity news and playing hip hop music and that. But here's the thing. I want to introduce Pharaoh and give him the platform because I met him through the promotions team at Beasley Media Group where I work. I work in the promotions and production department. And Pharaoh, for the next minute or two, promote the hell out of yourself and explain who you are because I actually want to know too.
Okay. So pretty much, you know, I get asked this a couple of times, you know, Pharaoh, what do you do? What do you like to do? Who are you? I like to say I'm a free spirit.
You are.
And I'm going to elaborate on that. I have no chosen path because there's so many paths that I want to follow. But primarily what I do in the city of Tampa, I'm a promoter. I work also for Y94.1 in the promotions department with my boy Hoppy.
Yeah, what up?
And of course, I do special events like pool parties, I'm everywhere. What else do? I love doing music. Music is one of my biggest passions. Me and my boy Slick are always out in the studio recording, making new bangers. I throw events for unsigned artists as well.
Yes, sir.
That's my other passion. I love seeing artistry. It could be any type of art, from music, from painting, from just being a creative. I'm just a passionate person towards the arts.
And that's why I thought about having you on the show. I was like, someone as outgoing as you would be good for the show because currently it's in a transition phase. Haven't really heard from my old co-host in about 4 weeks, but that's all good.
What a bummer.
Yeah. So what I'm saying is this. I'm saying I'm kind of doing different things where I'm having like a panel of people. Like my old co-host can come back as like a panel member, but it's one of those things where I'm actually, the show's growing now because I have this person on and this person on. And you are one of the funniest dudes I've ever met. Like the promo gigs we work, it's like 109 degrees out and you just have this sense of humor that's hilarious. And I want to ask you, with that sense of humor you have, do you follow celebrity news?
I try to follow a little bit, you know, mostly hip hop, but I do.
What the hell do you think of Michael Jordan's son? It says right here, Michael Jordan finally addresses his son dating Scottie Pippen's ex-wife. I mean, if that's not the most juicy thing you've ever heard, I don't know what is, bro.
I mean, this situation has been snowballing little by little. To everybody, it's no secret that right now, Michael Jordan's son is dating
Larsa.
Larsa.
I have the biggest crush on Larsa, bro. I would do naughty things to her.
I mean, she's not bad looking at all. And what's her age? I mean, does it
she's
say
she's like
right there?
48, I believe.
48.
The thing looking. Is, though, is like, I don't even care how old you are. Like, the experience, like, you know, she's wild.
Of course. Of course. She loves basketball players. So who knows the type of thing she's done.
And the thing, too, is you got to think that is a long list of NBA players she's hooked up with. I'm not sure which person would have hooked up with more NBA players, her or Lisa Ann. Those two love NBA players.
Of course. That's just the trend.
So here is Michael Jordan, and he was asked about if he approves of his son dating Larsa.
Hey, Mr. Jordan, what do you think about Marcus and Larsa Pippen together? You approve of it?
No.
You don't?
It's got to be weird, bro. Because you got to think, like, him and Scotty don't get along at all. And Scotty's got this weird vengeance against him where he's like, Michael was never good. Like, bitch, you would have never won a ring without him. And you also helped Jordan win a ring and you deserve all your flowers. But this whole Michael Jordan sucks, it's like, shut up. But the thing is this, it's, that's got to be even weird. Even though him and Scotty don't talk, that his son is banging the ex-wife of somebody they probably had fancy dinners with. Like, if you would have been Michael Jordan in the 90s, and let's say his son's 4 years old, if you would have said the kid that's crying at home in the mansion is going to bang this woman in 25 years, that's got to be mind-blowing.
Of course. It's mind-blowing and it's pretty, I mean, I think it's a slap. It's a slap in the face to Scotty because the animosity he has towards Michael is just outrageous. So for his son to end up smashing his wife, I don't know. Pippen, you might as well just take the donkey of the day. You lost. Take it home. Let it go.
He's got bad karma, though. Like, I really don't feel bad for Scotty because he goes on these podcasts and he is an absolute douchebag. Like, he goes on a Dan Patrick show and says, like, oh, Jordan would be nothing. But it's like, shut up. Like, I'm sorry. First of all, anybody who doesn't tip a waiter is a sociopath. I'm not saying you have to tip a lot of money, but he was literally known as no tipping Pippen in Chicago.
So put a pause on that. What's the right percentage that you think should be?
10 minimum, and it could be maximum if you don't have a, if you don't have a lot of money, 10%. Just give a little something. Even if you have nothing, give something. But to be no tipping Pippen, I mean, come on now. What about you?
I mean, I definitely agree. I mean, at least 20%, I feel like should be the minimum if you're out to, you know, treat somebody. If you're out to eat by yourself or you're at the bar. If you're buying a drink, it's different.
Yeah.
But if you're eating at a restaurant, it should be at least 20%. Because let's be mindful, these people are out here working for $5 an hour.
Yes.
They're out here losing time with their family. Let's work together. Let's go out there and throw a little extra $2. It's going to make somebody's day.
Now, if I were to tell you the name of a podcast called Separation Anxiety, what would you think the podcast would be about with the name Separation Anxiety? Who would be the host and what would be the vibe of Separation Anxiety?
I wouldn't know who would be the host, but I'd say it's about a human and a dog.
A human and a dog?
Yes.
I mean, I guess you could call Marcus Jordan a dog for banging a human known as Larsa. Here is these two talking about the fact that it seems like Larsa Pippen has lost money on her OnlyFans because she sees that, or the fans are seeing that Larsa's in a relationship, so they feel like they don't have a chance with her. And here's what I find fascinating is, whenever you're in a relationship with somebody who's creative, if they're in the past for me, it was a face painter. Whenever the dude lurks around the tent, the girl doesn't get as many sales because they go, oh, well, I don't have a shot with her. It's sort of the same thing with Larsa. I feel like Marcus is making all the fans go, oh, because like you can send girl. I've never actually paid for OnlyFans. There's that whole joke in life. Oh, I've never watched porn. I've never actually paid for OnlyFans and I wouldn't because Spank Bang is too good and I don't need to message girls and give them $10. I'll use the $10 on Netflix. But what I'm saying is that I bet a lot of people message Larsa and they have this fantasy that they have a chance. And then there's this.
How do you feel about my OnlyFans account? And would you ever want me to delete it? Because I would.
No, I mean, look, I don't have an issue with
OnlyFans.
You like
it, but you don't really like it.
No, I don't have a problem with it. I think as long as it makes you happy and you enjoy it, and you know, look, I think it's a source of income for you. Like,
I mean, source of income. What else is she going to do? Act or sing? She's a talentless idiot that married Scottie Pippen. I'm not saying she's not beautiful, but there's no talent there. Of course, that's going to be your source of income. What else are you going to do? Host a Tonight Show?
Well, it seems to me like Marcus is also might be taking some money from this. He might be a sugar baby.
I kind of get that vibe because I don't even know what he does for a job. And some of the most boring radio is when radio hosts Google things while on air. So I'm not going to Google what Marcus Jordan's job is. But at the same time, I don't think he's making $10 million bucks a year. So I bet he really lays down the pipe. I bet he gives her manliness and gives her the things she needs to fulfill her midlife crisis. And he's getting top-notch just sex. She just seems like... I've never, This is alleged. I've never hooked up with a sneaky link. There's been a few times throughout my single years during my one night hookups that the girl will be like, oh yeah, I got to go home to my husband. And I'm like, what? Have you ever had that?
I've never had that.
It's the worst feeling. I've had it like six times. And they will say, oh, but we're separated or whatever. That is the same type of sex that Larsa provides as the girls that I hooked up with, because they're sneaky links. They're freaky because they're not getting anything in their own life.
They're trying to fulfill something, a hole.
And having sex with a 6'9" radio host is literally the way to do it. It was the worst feeling, though. Imagine, I'm like, so what are you up to tonight? Oh, I got to go make dinner for my husband. And I'm like, because I would not have done it if it wasn't for that.
You kind of feel bad inside a little bit.
A lot of it, because I wouldn't have done it six times if I knew each time, because they would hide it. I have a past, man. I'm glad that my 20s is ending. I'm about to be 30 in less than 2 months, and I want the 20s to end. It's been a slutty, debaucherous, fascinating journey.
So it's a new chapter for you.
Yeah.
Where are we headed in this new chapter?
Yeah. Here's some more of the audio. I find this fascinating. It gets even better.
Like, I would never want to, you know, block your success or your, you know, well-being. And so, you know, I think as long as you enjoy it and use it as a career.
It's not good for business since I've been with you.
Well, hey, that's not my fault.
He's like, yeah, because I'm laying the pipe. You're not putting out as much desperate content because you don't feel the need. You don't have that void because I'm providing it. You know, like when a girl goes through a breakup or something and then they get really slutty on social media and then everyone's into it because they're trying to like rub it in the ex's face?
Exactly. You're just playing along.
Now, all of a sudden, she's not putting out as much content because she's getting that fulfillment from Marcus. So, of course, business is going to be down. I said when I talked about this on my previous podcast, you know how she could become the top creator? Because what does Marcus have to lose? I'm about to throw an idea to you. What does Marcus have to lose? Make videos. Do some POVs.
Why not?
I mean, literally, if you want your girl to make money and for her to keep giving you top-notch vacations with free sex, essentially, you got to make content.
I don't blame me.
Literally, the people that write me on there are like not happy that I'm in a relationship with you. But
I don't think any of the people, even if it's a millionaire paying for OnlyFans, I don't think any of them could afford her because they don't play basketball. You know what I mean? Like, I bet some rich accountant in Largo could pay for it and she wouldn't be into it.
She wouldn't care. I feel like right now she's looking for that celebrity vibe, also for somebody who has money.
She needs clout because she's a loser. I'm going to follow this. Separation_anxiety_podcast. This just looks riveting. Here's one. If we had one bank account, where would we both put it? Oh, this is going to be good. 856-49-HAPPY. It's 856-494-6773. Whenever I give out the number, that means I'm waiting for it to load.
One bank account where we both put in, I don't know, let's just say $2 million.
No big deal.
$3 million.
Okay.
Would you
three, I like that.
Two or three.
I like that.
Who do you think would be more responsible with that $2 or $3 million?
Of course, Marcus, because he needs to like handle his money because he's rich, but he's not that rich. Larsa seems like the type of woman that just all of a sudden goes, I want to spend $50,000 this afternoon at the mall.
She sounds like an emotional wreck, and the money is the solution to it.
Me or you? Just asking for a friend.
That's a loaded question. Yeah, I got to trust you. Okay. You're very conservative when it comes to spending. You spend on the right stuff.
Here's the answer to that. When he's saying, you're very conservative, I trust you, he's saying, without you, I wouldn't have this life.
Happy hour.
Oh, man, we're going to come back real quick. But first, here's Lucas Brown with No Choice, only on Happy Hour. Damn, bro, I just hit the post.
I got no choice. We stealthy with the come up, we make no noise. I'm riding in the foreign, it's a Rolls Royce. Slap the hate up out of your voice. Yeah, I got no choice. I had to be successful for my homeboys. We pull up on your squad, we got more boys. We got them diamond dancing, I got more toys. I'ma be the greatest this city's ever seen. Mark it in your calendars, I'm coming for your team. That's a fact. Oh, no, that's a fact. Yeah, that's a fact, bro. There ain't no cap, no. You talk to me with
with hate, then you just might get slapped. Oh, you're trying to front now, you getting shut down. I don't do field goals, though, I just go for touchdowns. Yeah, they all wanna be like me. You missing from the box, and I'm scoring from the three. Yeah, and I come with no degree. Messing with your girl, and she like you when she see. Oh, this is gazy, y'all. When you walk into your city, you bring shame to all. When I walk into my city, it's my name to call. Putting in the work must be insane to y'all. I got no choice. We stealthy with the come up, we make no noise. I'm riding in the foreign, it's a Rolls Royce. I go and slap the hate up out of your voice. Yeah. Oh, I got no choice. I had to be successful for my homeboys. We pull up on your squad, we got more boys.
I got more toys, and they bigger now. I got more toys, and they asking how. I'm headed straight to the top, throw me a lob, this is a bop. If it looks good, I cop, get my shoes and socks. I'm on a boat, you at a dock, you all floor, I am a mop. Hop on my drop top, give me the ox, I'm about to pop off. Y'all already know, I'm about to pop off. I cannot stop, no, I just keep going and going and going. I cannot stop, yeah. Yo, I pull up with a gang, and I'ma still bang. I might cop a range, if I want it, I'ma get it. I got it, forget it, yeah.
Yeah. Successful, there ain't any other way. I never give the code to the safe. It's destiny, I ain't gotta say. It's no, I'ma get it anyway. I got no choice. We stealthy with the come up, we make no noise. I'm riding in the foreign, it's a Rolls Royce. I go and slap the hate up out of your voice, yeah. I had to be successful for my homeboys. I pull up on your squad, we got more boys. I got them diamond dancing, I got more toys.
This following segment has been brought to you by Mitra 9. When I tell you that they are the best kava and kratom around, I am a man of my words. Go to tinyurl.com/hoppymitra and at checkout, use keyword hoppy. This has also been brought to you by DZ BZ Honey, the best Delta 8 CBD honey around. Go to dzbzhoney.com/hoppy and there you can save 20%. Here's some music that Froggy from the MJ Morning Show made. I made a post looking for like music beds, and Froggy messaged me and was like, I have a ton of them. We're going to come back, and we have so much to get into. I'm already digging the show. It's been about 18 minutes, you know? And I think it's been a good vibe. I think it's been a good time, but you can only get better.
Happy hour. Happy hour.
Call Hoppy now, 856-49-HOPPY. Tweet at him at Ryan Hoppy Radio.
It's time to turn Hoppy on.
Please don't be offended. He's sorry in advance.
Ladies and gentlemen, here it is, the most listened to radio show on the planet. Even the other stations are tuned in too.
Let's get into it. I love some celebrity trash.
No! Happy Hot Topic!
Oh, man. I won't be perfect a day in my life. A lot of other podcasts would go, oh, two things played over each other. I'm going to edit it. I'm never perfect a day in my life. What's going on with Khloe?
Khloe Kardashian is counting down the days until her next birthday. After turning 39 on June 27th, the Good American founder says she's ready to say goodbye to her 30s, calling...
I bet your 30s are ready to say goodbye to you. You've been annoying this whole time and kept going back to an NBA player that cheated on you over and over again. I find her to be the most unlikable Kardashian because I don't respect women that keep going back to cheaters over and over again and getting the same results. Like Kim and them have, and Kourtney have been through divorces, but Khloe just kept taking Thompson back. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, there should definitely be a line of respect for a woman.
Mm-hmm.
I definitely love the Kardashians. They all got their own story. They got their own drama.
They're fun to talk about.
We all love it. You know, we're all part of their life.
It's fun to talk about, bro. Like, people go, why do you talk about the Kardashians or whatever? Do you want me to talk about Hunter Biden being a deadbeat piece of shit and that our president is always asleep and sucks and Trump sucked too? No, because people that are listening disagreed with one of the things I said. But we can all agree that it's fun to make fun of the Kardashians.
There's never a dull moment with the Kardashians. But yeah, this woman, as much as she was loved, she ruined it with this...
She looks so different. I thought her old Amazon look was kind of sexy because she was like thick and beautiful. And then she like literally changed her face. And then she goes, I don't like when people say that I changed my face. Well, then don't change your face, dummy.
Calling it, quote, the worst decade ever. While Khloe generally thinks showing off her birthday gifts is, quote, sort of obnoxious, she couldn't resist sharing some of them with her Snapchat fam.
You know what that's equivalent to when you say this is obnoxious for me to show something, but I'm going to do it anyway, is when somebody insults you and goes, I love you, man, but I think your music sucks. I love you, man, but I don't think you should get married. You ever have that where somebody critiques you and they don't want to full on insult you because they're a pussy? So they go, yeah, I think you're really talented, but.
It's that love and hate relationship. And we're obviously seeing it right here.
Hell yeah.
Because I think it's sort of obnoxious, but this one was too funny. I hate being in my 30s. I think it's the worst decade ever. And I can.
If she thinks her 40s is going to be any better, she is a dummy. Because then she's going to go full midlife crisis. How long until she dates a Gen Z? That's what's going to happen next. Is she's going to date like a 2000 baby. And the whole show is going to be, ha ha, you don't remember 9/11. Ha ha. Speaking of that. Wow, I am so good at this. I can't do TikTok. Do you do TikTok?
TikTok is amazing. I don't always do it. I'm more into Instagram.
Me too.
But TikTok definitely has a hold of me in about those 3 a.m. hours.
Yeah. To me, it's mindless junk. It's equivalent to eating a lot of McDonald's. Like when you're full on hungry and you think you need 5 McDoubles, it's the same feeling I get after going on TikTok. And I'm cool with any other TikTok trend that's ever been around. But this next one is really pissing me off because it's an example that teachers in the last 22 years, I never rip into teachers because they have a hard job, but it's either teachers or the parents of the last 22 years have failed at letting the next generation that didn't experience 9/11 know how frightening 9/11 was.
It was something different that I feel like the new generation will never get to experience.
And they think it's funny. Have you seen the new TikTok trend?
I have not.
All right. I've seen videos of it. I don't know what the name of the TikTok trend is, but the concept, because I saw multiple videos, so either people are copying the idea or it's a trend. But it's a skit where you're doing something in the living room, which first of all, it was in the morning, so nobody was really in the living room unless they were getting ready for work. So that idea already failed. It wasn't like it was 7 p.m. at night, dumbasses. But they'll be in the living room and they'll be like, oh, yeah, I need to go do and see my accountant. Oh, my God. Do you see what's on TV? Where they're like mid conversation in their living room and then they're pointing at the TV going, holy shit, what's going on? And then on the TV, it's showing like 9/11. It's corny as fuck. And if you would have told me, and I'm not very patriotic, I think this country sucks in a lot of ways, but if you would have told me 22 years later that those babies would find that funny, we failed. Do you get what I'm saying? Like, it's where they're doing something. They're like, oh yeah, I need to go play PS4. But why is the TV like that? Like, that's not how it was. Everybody was either at school or at work. So if they think it was while it was at home, because the way the skits are set, it looks like it's like dinner time. So they don't even know that it was at like 9:15 in the morning.
Well, let's be realistic.
What?
After all the submarine jokes, all lines were erased. There was no more respect. There was like dark humor has reached another level. So at this point, I kind of expect that.
I just couldn't. It made me realize that we failed as a society within 20 years. Like, we literally failed at teaching about 9/11. And you know what I think the biggest problem is? Teachers don't really teach about it. You know what you need to do for every single class is go to YouTube, type in 9/11 CNN, and for the whole day, make them watch the CNN broadcast. Then you'll never forget it. But when you barely want to teach it, because I've heard rumors from my cousins, I don't know this for sure because I don't have any kids and I don't want kids because I got a vasectomy. But what I'm saying is I literally know that teachers didn't want to share kids the video because it would trigger them. Bitch, how about us 90s babies that were scared as fuck? Dad, I try not to swear on this show because I want to get on the radio, but this is fucking bullshit. If you think you're going to trigger other people, how do you think we felt?
No, it's definitely big disrespect for the young generation to be using a situation like that who affected America completely to make it into a joke. But I feel your pain.
That's all I'm going to talk about with that. I just think we failed. I couldn't believe it. Like, a 9/11 one-liner isn't funny, but you go, that's a dark joke. But if you're making full-on videos about it, no, like, if you're making full-on videos, not a joke at the bar when you're drunk as hell, or Gilbert Gottfried, where he got in trouble for the 9/11 jokes. If you're full-on making videos about it, and it's only been 20 years, we failed.
Did you ever make a submarine joke?
No, but I don't really feel bad for them. Why are you going that low under the water when you know you're going to die? Like, that's just, like, you're putting your life at risk. I like being alive for as long as I can be. I feel bad because they're dead, but that's just rich people that are bored. Just go have a lot of food in Mexico or go on a crazy vacation. Why do you need to go underwater? And James Cameron's done it. To me, James Cameron is the equivalent to a radio person, and I'm working on this factor, a radio person that only is their radio persona and nothing else. Like, if he's really full-on experiencing Titanic over and over 25 years later, he's got no personality. Like, if you're having to go underwater, you're a weird guy.
Yeah, more than one time, you're actually looking for death.
You really are. 856, that is such a transition that is exciting. So I want to be in a good mood right now, so we're going to play some music. 856-49-HOPPY. This next artist here is somebody I met at the Chill Room, which is a Cava and Kratom bar, and he hosts the Cava Spills podcast, and his name is LB2, and here is Cava Spills on Happy Hour.
Happy Hour. Happy Hour.
Stay up off my line, by the side, got this function vibing, yeah, I'm doing fine, free to slime, cop controlling all the time, cross my T's and count my dimes, if it ain't about a bag, please don't waste my fucking time, yo, 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 if it ain't about a bag, please don't waste my fucking time, Gucci slides in the Louis store, I ain't picking sides, fill that shell up to the rim, dog, is this your first time? Cop a shell, got me sitting way back, sitting alone with my thoughts back, keep calling my name, yeah. Yeah, I hear, tell him I call him back, yeah. Tell him I'm busy out here, get me racks, yeah. Give me a beat, I'm going on full attack, yeah. The game of the crown and not even on him back, yeah. When the game is mine, I'm taking it to the max, yeah.
Keep calling me back, I'm loading up the Mac, I'm counting up the steps, so baby. Stinking like a Shaq, I told her throw it back, I'm flowing down the track, oh baby. I've been sipping cover. Still in cover. I don't think it's a problem. Miss me with a drama, baby.
Keep calling me back, but I don't ever answer. Yeah, I got some ones on me, but I ain't a dancer. Never giving up the fight like I'm beating cancer. Till your ass and bring you back, I'm the necromancer. Then I get high and fly away. Ain't no stressing out, we save it for another day. Got my shell in my hand and now I'm in the daze. Working hard for this shit, I'ma need a raise. But you know I don't expect it though. You don't have to like the grind, but you need to
step the flow. Feeling muddy out my mind, almost missed my exit hope. Trapping restless, dropping dimes, gotta keep the status quo. Now that's a rare trait nowadays. Too legit, I ain't scared of Jake nowadays. Chicken tenders eating collard cake off their graves. LB2, hold me up, we about to blaze.
Just kidding, I'm at work. That's for later, allegedly, because of my medical card. Are you ready to trip out, bro? I got some Romeo on. This is Romeo's music.
Really?
You ready to trip out?
I'm ready for it.
Here is 222, Call on Me. I want to go on ayahuasca right now. Hang out with Aaron Rodgers and vomit.
I feel like I'm laying in the grass right now looking at the stars. Like,
hell yeah.
Where the constellations at?
I mean, look at our window we have here. You can look at the clouds and kind of trip out. This following segment's been brought to you by the best barber in all of the Bay Area, Rich Keeley. Go to richkbarber.com. And you can sign up for a beard trim, haircut, whatever the hell you need. But first, let's let, I'm going to guess here, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's let the beat drop. You like how I did that?
That was dope.
Thanks. I have this song memorized. If you go to richkbarber.com and you sign up for a haircut, you'll get hooked up. But here's the thing. You might have to wait a few days because he's booked a lot. But you don't need to go to one of the chain places and get a half-ass haircut. It's worth the wait. Also, I got some good news today. There have been many sales for the hemp CBD Delta 8 lemonade that I promote. Happy Hour listeners are having fun and allegedly getting high because of me, bro. Astrobleme.com. Astrobleme.com. And at checkout, use keyword HOPPE, Hoppy, to save 10%. My guy Mike sent me a text about it today. I was like, hell yeah. Because I want to be, I hate the word influencer, but for Tampa Radio, the way that people I've previously worked with in that, that will remain nameless, that influenced the sexual talk radio of Tampa Bay, I want to be the one that makes the beautiful plant the thing. That's my goal, to have a show where it's like, it's 420, let's smoke up.
You gotta bring the cameras out for that one. You gotta have the juice right there in front of you. You gotta have one rolled up.
You know,
and allegedly be high.
You know what you need? You need all the politicians to get off their asses and go, let's make it recreational. Because until then, it's just medicine.
Happy hour. Happy hour.
Live from Tampa Bay, you are tuned in to Happy Hour.
Ladies and gentlemen, here it is, the most listened to radio show on the planet. Even the other stations are tuned in too.
Pharaoh, do you know much about the whole dating triangle of Selena Gomez, Hailey Bieber, and her husband?
Listen, my girl loves this topic, and she would go crazy to even speak on it.
Do you know, relate to me right now, Pharaoh. relay to me what your girl says, and then we'll play this news clip. Because I want to hear from, like, an actual fan. Like, I cover it, and I know about it, but someone that's, like, your girl that's, like, full-on fan, whenever you're hanging out with her and she's on TikTok and sees a post about it, what is the overall consensus that your girl says?
All right, well, to me, this seems like a Twilight saga, but
yeah,
and about celebrities, pop stars. So definitely you got Team Selena.
Yes.
And then you got Team Hailey. And, you know, my boy Justin Bieber, the player that he is, representing Canada and going crazy.
Hell yeah. Are you from Canada?
I'm not from Canada. I'm actually from Colombia, South America.
Oh.
But, hey, they both started with a C.
Hell yeah, dog.
So listen, yes, Justin Bieber, the player that he is, the freaking hot boy, super rich.
Hot boy summer.
Yes. He's still stuck on Selena. I've always thought that. I think that the love that Justin Bieber has for Selena is that Tupac and Jada?
Yeah.
Tupac and Jada love. Like it's beyond barriers. Yeah, he got married to another woman, you know, but sometimes you might end up in the wrong house.
You know the show Honey Boo Boo?
Is that with the lady who teaches people how to dance, like the girls?
No, Honey Boo Boo is that white trash show from 10 years ago where it was that little kid that was talking about being like a redneck and then her mom was really ugly and fat.
Yes, yes.
That mom is better looking than Jada. I find Jada to be a repulsive person. And you can make and show me pictures of her from 20 years ago where she looks beautiful.
Yes.
And I just think that Jada is a dirty rod and see you next Tuesday. I despise everything about her.
I mean, her as a woman...
Her personality makes her ugly. I don't care. You can show me a picture of her looking fine.
Okay.
Her being such a sociopathic imbecile makes her a zero.
But you know, like a lot of people say that supposedly they're swingers. A lot of people say...
Supposedly, of course they are. She's banging a 22-year-old. She's a cougar that's bald.
Listen, their situation made Will Smith look like...
A bitch.
A loser.
Yeah.
A bozo. You know, so... People still have respect for Will, but after the whole situation, it's like, Will, like, this woman took your manhood. You might as well have left her and done her dirty because she had zero respect after the August Alsina situation. That was just disrespectful for hip-hop. It was disrespectful for Will Smith. It was disrespectful to the Matrix.
Yeah.
I don't even know what was going on.
Going back to Bieber, you know what I've always thought of Hailey?
Tell me.
Sneaky Link. She's a side chick. He was kind of getting sick of Selena, so she was a clout-chasing Baldwin that needed some type of fame because she doesn't really contribute much. So he began banging her on the side. She looks like, because I've seen it in radio, she looks like your typical side chick. Hailey looks like a side chick.
Look, above all that, Selena is way more beautiful than her, and that's just what it is straight up.
And it's nothing more and nothing less than the fact that Selena probably always wanted to hang out at home, didn't want to do much, and Hailey was like, oh my God, let's go to the club because I want to spend money because I don't know how to have fun at home.
Whoa! Happy Hot Topic!
Here is Hailey Bieber slamming made-up Selena Gomez feud rumors.
That's awful. I hate it.
Hailey Bieber is done with, quote, made-up feud rumors between her and Selena Gomez. The model turned entrepreneur is reflecting on the, quote, twisted and perpetuated narratives that's...
Of course there's narratives! You were the sneaky link that was around! Don't be a sneaky link. Have a legitimate relationship and nothing will happen. You know who she is?
Where is
this, she? This next... alleged sneaky link side chick I'm about to mention is one that I could not mention when I worked in sports radio. I actually got in trouble when I mentioned it on air.
Who is this talented woman?
She's actually richer. Giselle.
Giselle. Giselle who?
Bundchen. Tom Brady's ex-wife.
Oh, let's not talk about that dirty piece of shit of a woman.
Dude. So he knocked up Bridget Moynihan in like 07, 08. I've done all the research on it. And right after he began dating Giselle. Right after. Oh, I bet he waited until they were officially broken up to begin banging Giselle. There was no crossover there. But oh, Tom Brady plays football and is around his kids 10% of the year. Oh, but he's man of the year. We had to kiss his ass in Tampa. Thank you for the Super Bowl. But man, when I worked in sports radio, I had so many opinions about that, and they're like, no, you can't say that. I'm like, okay. It's the truth.
Everybody was praising him. But look, before we even jump on the Giselle situation,
yes,
let's not forget how Selena Gomez did my boy The Weeknd. Like, that should have showed everybody what type of piece of shit she was as well. So, dude, she's a heartbreaker. She's a player. And that's why my boy Justin Bieber had to move on. It was just time.
Surfaced online regarding the two ladies earlier this year while appearing in an episode of The Circuit with Emily Chang.
I don't think that this is about me, Hailey Bieber, and Selena Gomez. This is not about this pitting between two women and division.
Then what is it about? Harry Potter? Of course it's about you.
Between two women. It's about the vile.
She doesn't even know what the fuck to say. I'm trying not to swear, but it's a podcast. She's like, and there's like 3 seconds of dead air. She's lying so badly. She doesn't even know what she's saying. And she's trying to think, what have I said before? Because I don't want to say something new.
Vile, disgusting hatred that can come from completely made up and twisted and perpetuated narratives that can be really dangerous.
The Roadskin founder added that the division this rumored feud has caused is something she does not stand for. However,
then don't cheat. I gotta discuss this. So many people in Tampa cheat, bro. It is crazy. This is the cheating capital of America.
That's the new nickname.
Literally. I have seen so many people cheat, and the excuse is, oh, well, the relationship's hard. Break up then. Break up suck. But hey, at least you have the dignity to break up. Oh my God. But the thing that drives me nuts, that drives me out of this world about cheating, besides the fact that we don't want to talk about it, you're sharing bodily fluids with someone else. Oh, but I don't want to think about how gross it is. That's what it is. Sorry. Their mouth is going on someone else. You get the point. Here's the thing. I hate when people cheat and then they don't like the consequences of it. Oh, why is everybody talking about the infidelity? Why is everyone doing this? Because you fucking cheated. That's the consequence. Sort of like how there's the consequence of Barry Bonds not going into the Hall of Fame because he cheated in baseball. You broke the rules. You cheated.
That's just what it is. And Tampa Bay is the number one capital of cheaters. And I see this every weekend at every event.
I have to see it wherever I go. I've seen people of power do it. And you go, and they make it seem like their relationship's legit. I go, come on now. And then you're at a party and you see that couple that cheats on each other trying to act like they're monogamous. Like, get out of here. You think any of us are not being fooled by it? I'm talking about anybody. Anybody that goes to a fancy party and brings their wife that they're cheating on 20 times a month, and then they both look miserable like they're being held without their will. Come on, just divorce already.
The problem these days is nobody wants to start over, or nobody wants to feel like,
you know what, it's the best. It did, though. You know what? My last three relationships have failed, but not talking to that person for the rest of my life feels good because it wasn't meant to be. You know what I'm saying? Amen. People can rip into you all day. Oh, you dumped somebody. Hey, at least you're not Haley or Selena. Speaking of sneaky links, this next song is the official sneaky link anthem for all you cheaters out there in Tampa Bay. Let me make sure I pronounce this right. She has it on the bottom. It's Balia from the promotions department. Her name is Blasi Aga, and she's got Like It, which you're going to like it when your wife's at home doing homework with the kids while you're paying for a nice motel with cash you took out of your ATM.
Before that, you could what's your fantasy? Tell me what you want from me. Tell me what it's gonna be. You and me in the sheets. Tell me what you're gonna do. When I put this ass on you. And baby, if it's cool with you, I want you to act the fool. Baby, don't you know that I just want you so bad. Tell me that you're feeling the same as me. Cause you know I've been waiting. But you keep on playing. Come and put your body all over me. You should come on over. I will not be sober. Put you on the sofa. I'm not trying to know you. Told you once before that you could get your soul snatched. I could throw it way back. Oh, I know you like it. I know you like it. For a ride, fuck with me, I'll get you right. Make it last all night. It's whatever you wanna do. I'ma leave it up to you. And I'ma have you feeling new. Whenever we get through, what you doing later? Stop being a player. Come on and lay up with me. Cause you know I've been waiting. But you keep on playing. I just want you one time of me. You should come on over. I will not be sober. Get you on the sofa. I'm not trying to know ya. Told you once before that you could get your soul snatched. I could throw it way back. I know you like it. I know you like it all.
Oh yeah. This following segment has been brought to you by Westchaseprinting.com. They are the best printing company in all the Bay Area. I have my business cards printed from there. You can get yard signs, whatever the hell you need. Also, I'm going to tell you about other sponsors, but this is Sippin' Sojo, or Soho, S-O-J-U, by Romeo. I need to party with Romeo and Ybor. There's a difference between us working promo where we have to be responsible. For my dirty 30s, I want to go hard. Especially my birthday, September 3rd, which is a Sunday. So September 1st is First Friday. So my plan is get lit on that Friday and then Saturday go to Ybor.
Definitely Fridays in St. Pete are nevertheless a great time. So definitely I recommend St. Pete.
And you know what's fun is you feel safe in downtown St. Pete because the cops in downtown St. Like the cops in Ybor, I feel are looking for anything to get an arrest. But the cops in downtown St. Pete will let anything happen because they're looking for the crazy people. I feel protected when the cops are around the block by like Joey Brooklyn's Pizza and Janice Live. Because crazy things happen down there and they're just waiting for that. The cops in downtown St. Peter are... Cops are never your homies. But the cops in downtown St. Pete are looking for things.
Personally, I feel the opposite. I feel like more safe in Ybor City and St. Pete, since they're not so close, it's anything can happen.
Dude, the things that happen, though, in Ybor is wild.
Of course, of course. But you have to think about how big Ybor is compared to downtown St. Pete. Downtown St. Pete's a square. So it's
it really, really is. I guess I never thought about that. I've heard cities like Panama City and that are like pretty much the size of downtown St. Pete. St. Pete fascinates me because I moved here in 2015 and it seemed like everything was growing by the minute. And now it feels like it's dying more. I think it might have to do with the fact that no one seems to be buying those apartments that nobody can afford in this economy. Those apartments are so empty in downtown St. Pete. Do you ever see anybody in those high rises walking out of it? That was a lame project. I don't know what was more lame, that or that joke of a place called The Trop. Can we quit pretending that place is nice?
That place is really horrible. I think that right now they're trying to figure out what to do with it. No concerts are booked there. The games suck. The Rays, you know what? I'm sorry. They've been all right, but I not good enough.
All right. I got to be careful how I say this. I'm thinking here. Think about where I was the last year in radio, if you followed. They're not going to Tampa. They're not going to Ybor. This is all alleged. Made this up. This is all fiction. I'm writing a book called What's Going to Happen When the Rays Don't Ever Move Out and Are in the Trop for the Next 30 Years. That's all I got to say.
Happy Hour.
Call Hoppy now. 856-49-HOPPY. Tweet at him at Ryan Hoppy Radio.
It's time to turn Hoppy on.
He never holds back, and he speaks his mind. Welcome back to Hoppy Hour.
Ladies and gentlemen, here it is. The most listened to radio show on the planet. Even the other stations are tuned in too.
Hoppy. It's 856-494-6773. You can tweet at me at Ryan Hoppy Radio. You can always email me, ryanhoppyradio@gmail.com. Now, if you don't have your medical card, you are not allowed to listen to this next segment.
On the subject of narcotics in general, but most marijuana in particular. That is the purpose.
This is from marijuanamovement.net. FDA and FTC sends warning letters about copycat Delta 8 THC products resembling popular food brands. Man, the FDA and FTC is being party poopers. Those are the best, allegedly. The best ones is the ones that look like food.
Those are definitely the best ones and the ones that are actually attractive to eat and actually buy.
I'm not going to read this headline, but pretty much there's mad. I did all the research in the headline, so I'm doing the Ryan Hoppy recap. Pretty much, it's nothing more and nothing less than they're mad that there's products that people have had that they thought were really chips, but got them high. So they're mad that there's copycat-looking Doritos that get you high.
The Doritos might be called, I don't even know what you would call them.
I don't even know. But here's what it was like. If you go to Aldi's and get a name brand, non-name brand, like their version of Doritos or whatever, they are mad about the copycats at like smoke shops that look like, let's say, Skittles, but they give you a better effect.
Mm-hmm. Way better effect. I mean, FDA.
That's all alleged. This is all alleged.
FDA, you need to calm down and let us have a good time. And
FDA
relax.
Needs to get high and relax. You know what, FDA? I know you're not the one that comes up with the rules, but if you make it all recreational, then we'll be fine. Oh, people out there listening, Ryan Hoppy's talking about marijuana. You know what it is? This is from marijuanamovement.net again. But this is weed news. You ready for this next headline? People that are always about science need to always be about science. People sometimes go, I'm really into science, but I don't like when they say that there's no afterlife because there's a heaven. Here's another example. Marijuana is safer than alcohol and cigarettes and is less addictive than technology, Americans say in a new survey. It's literally science. I know it's a survey, but you know what I'm saying? They're literally saying that alcohol and cigarettes and internet is worse than smoking the plant. Literally.
There is no way they can match that. Like, it's not real. It's impossible. Marijuana, I support it. I love it. But technology is way more addictive.
Dude, I think technology is my cigarettes. It's frightening how addicted I am to it. It's actually legit scary. people think, oh, you drink kava. You must be addicted to kava. Or you must be addicted to weed. No, 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 no. Literally, my iPhone, I cannot go 30 seconds without being on that thing. I literally, dude, working promo events, I got scolded for being on it. And I don't go on it anymore. But over and over, I just want to text people. I'm addicted, bro.
It's a sick new disease that they don't warn you about.
Yeah.
Things like TikTok, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, they're all playing a role into that. And that's something that they're not paying attention to. And, you know, the same doctors that make these claims that marijuana is less addictive than technology and cigarettes are the same ones that allowed cocaine being coke. So what can we do?
Oh, cocaine, the thing that is absolutely frightening. I'm telling you right now that I think if you were to die of a cocaine overdose, that would be the saddest thing ever.
Cocaine.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like whenever I hear that a person died of cocaine, this is sound effects off of YouTube. I'm not doing a line right now. I'm telling you right now, whenever you hear someone dies of a cocaine overdose, you're like, I'm sorry, bud. You got the wrong batch and you're at a party and you got peer pressured.
Yeah, what a sucker.
Do you ever think about that, though, whenever you see that? Or like fentanyl? Like, you can't trust it, bro. The only one you can trust. NBA signs contract removing NBA or removing. Let's do that. Take two. NBA officially signed contract removing marijuana from banned substances list and allowing players to invest in cannabis companies. You know what that is? Adam Silver probably tokes a lot and was like, let's just do it, guys.
Listen, NBA is not doing this just for no reason. I'm pretty sure they're going to pickpocket some money out of this.
Of course they are.
Because let's be real, it's not. This didn't just happen out of love.
Nah, they're not like, you know what? Let's let John Morant get high and pose with guns.
No, but let's be real. Imagine see LeBron playing high. That's going to be something fun.
Dude, there's going to be players that might have less pressure about the buzzer beater. You might have players, like what if in 3 years they let you play high and then all of a sudden James Harden is actually not choking in the playoffs? Like what if it's anxiety that is the reason he goes 3-for-18 whenever you need him to win one game?
We might see that, or we actually might see Curry miss a shot.
Yeah. I find James Harden to be the funniest player ever. All the talent until it's game 6 or 7. Literally, unbeatable. The best ever. Game 6 or 7, nope. I can't do anything game 6 or 7 is literally what he says. It should say, they should have a new thing on NBA jerseys where you have a motto and you have like a saying. And James Harden would just be, every time you need me to show up, I am not there because I am hungover from banging a bunch of girls last night.
Happy hour. Happy hour.
Oh, yeah. What the hell should we play right now? Let's do some more LB2. Riding through my city. Oh, yeah. You grab your plant or your shell of kava, and you're listening to Happy Hour, and this song chills you out.
My city, yeah. My crown looking pretty. All my girls are dead.
All my girls are dead.
Yeah. I'm grinding like I'm filthy. Got my hand on my 50. You know I keep it with me. Don't try me, it gets sticky.
No.
My dogs in here with me. They with that nitty gritty.
Yeah.
Sacking cash to the ceiling, sipping shells for the healing. Give a damn how they feeling. Rising above is a must. Yeah. Family's all I trust. Keeping my foot on their neck while keeping some root in my cup. Been running this game for a while. No wonder they showing me love. Can't learn how to strip in a day. You want my advice? Give it up. Give it up. Took a minute, took my time, and now we up. Shots to Wheezy, man, don't talk about my cup. I'm on that Marley vibe, I'm here to stir it up. Where's the love? I'm just riding up.
I'm just riding through my city, man. Music bumping, heads swinging. Ain't nobody holding me back. I'm just riding through my city, man. I'm just trying to keep my record clean. I'm just sitting great, living roofless, hands spinning great, getting. Ain't nobody holding me back.
Yeah.
I'm just riding through my city, man.
Zach boy.
I'm just riding.
Yeah, I'm just riding around the bird, keeping watch for the birds. Got the keys, say the word, say the word. Yeah, my life is so absurd, holding flock for the herd on the mud.
Sorry,
slurs. And I'm never crapping out. Rolling sevens on the dice, homie. Why you showing out?
You showing out?
Do it all without a doubt. Staying muddy in a drought. Stack them up, I do a count. Focused on the numbers and I'm running them up. And my people out here crazy and they running them up. Got a bat from overseas and we load up the truck. If you're praying on my downfall, you boys out of luck.
You know I'm cool as a puck. All this ice I'm displaying. Drinking shell after shell.
Then to the porcelain I'm praying. I get up and I'm swaying. And I stumble outside. I put myself back together. Then I jump in my ride.
Ride.
I'm just riding through my city, man. Music bumping, hands swinging. Ain't nobody holding me back. I'm just riding through my city, man. I'm just trying to keep my record clean.
Man,
problems in the grain, dripping roof, missing hair, spinning bread, getting. Ain't nobody holding me back. I'm just riding through my city, man. I'm just riding through my city, man.
I'm always riding through the city in my fuel-efficient Honda Accord. Until I begin making big boy radio money, I love driving Accords, bro, because literally, it's such a good vibe because you save a lot of money on gas. What do you drive?
I currently drive a 2014 Toyota Camry.
Fuel-efficient.
I love the Camrys. They're so smooth. If I ever had to buy a new car, it would like 98% chance be a new Camry.
Hell yeah. 856-49-HOPPY. This following segment's been brought to you by a few different people. Oh, Romeo. Soothe me with your trippiness. And the panic attack this is giving me. I'm just kidding. This has been brought to you by, if you need to work on your mental health, which Romeo is really big on and he gives me a lot of advice, you also can go to counselingoncall.net and get your own therapist either in person, in Zoom, or on the speakerphone. I'll be talking to my shrink, Jay, and it'll literally be me on the speakerphone. I'll be at the pool, in my apartment, or cleaning my cat's litter box, or doing the laundry. It's always when I first wake up in the morning, and it's just someone I bitch about things to. And it's good for my mental health. Do you see anybody? Are you crazy or are you normal?
I'm a little crazy.
You seem a little crazy.
I'm a little weird too. You're weird.
You go to counselingoncall.net, and when you get that therapist, if you tell them you heard about it on Happy Hour, they will hook you up. This has also been brought to you by Amir Academy of Martial Arts at AmirAcademy.com in St. Pete. Women's self-defense classes, kids classes, MMA classes, a workout room, whatever the hell you need. If you go to Amir Academy of Martial Arts and tell them I sent you, they will hook you up. This has also been brought to you by FitSageFitness.net. Devin Prasad, one of my closest friends. He's got a mobile app at FitSageFitness.net. You can do different workout plans. I don't know if you noticed this, but I only surround myself with the best in the Bay, which is why I work at Beasley Media Group. Oh, man, I was so busy kissing a little bit of ass that I forgot to turn off the music. You can't just be giving people flowers but not paying attention to your own show.
Happy Hour. Happy Hour.
Listen to Hoppy Hour at any time, anywhere. Search Hoppy Radio on all major streaming platforms.
Ladies and gentlemen, here it is, the most listened to radio show on the planet. Even the other stations are tuned in too.
What the hell is going on with Meta? What is Mark Zuckerberg copying now? The most unoriginal original guy of all time. He's sort of like the Seth MacFarlane of social media. Like Seth MacFarlane copied The Simpsons, but it's successful. MySpace was first. Zanga was too.
Whoa! Happy Hot Topic!
I never had Zanga. I just heard about it. What's going on with Meta?
It's the battle of the billionaires. After Elon Musk recently challenged Mark Zuckerberg to a potential cage match, and Zuckerberg agreed, the two have yet to physically face off.
I wonder what it'd be like if they even met. We were talking about this at our promo gig at Galaxy Fireworks. We were talking to Keith Connors, who is on Middays in 99.5 QIK, and you were saying that you don't even think it's going to be a real fight because Elon's not really that tough because he's actually on the spectrum. And number two, that this would probably be nothing more and nothing less than AI.
Yeah, this is definitely going to be a project where AI is going to make its mark, is going to make a difference. And it's going to show everybody how good it is to fool somebody. So for everybody who's believing that they're actually going to fist fight and fight to the death in the Coliseum, you are a goofy.
Dude, Zuckerberg literally looks like he's dead. Like he looks like he should be laying in a casket. He doesn't look like he's alive.
You know why? Because he's a lizard.
But the source of their dispute, Zuckerberg's company Meta, is now entering the ring to take on Twitter.
I'll copy IG. I'll copy MySpace. I'll copy Periscope. Time to copy Twitter.
I enjoy being doubted.
And now
you enjoy copying others. No one's doubting you. Who has ever doubted Mark Zuckerberg? Oh, what a loser Zuckerberg is. Maybe they doubted him 20 years ago at Harvard when no one liked him because he was a creep. But one of you, honestly, what a narcissist. You know what that is? That's equivalent to when Travis Kelce was acting like the Chiefs were the underdogs. We've been the underdogs the whole year, even though we have one of the best quarterbacks of all time. It's the same thing with Mark. People are doubting me. No one's doubting you. You literally created the biggest thing ever. When has anybody ever doubted? You ever doubted Zuckerberg?
Never, especially with the success of Instagram. Who can be mad at him?
That's what I'm saying. This mindset of his. Oh, everyone's doubting me. No one is, bro. Get over yourself.
Take on Twitter.
I enjoy being doubted.
Announcing the launch of a direct competitor, Threads. The app, which appears to emphasize public conversations, much like Twitter, already showing up in Apple's App Store for users to download on Thursday.
I'm downloading it tonight.
Photo previews suggest users will be able to log in using their Instagram account.
Take all my info. I don't care. I have nothing to hide. I literally go to work, go home, watch porn and go to bed. There's nothing I need to hide. Take all my info. Make me famous.
Meta is the biggest social media company in the world. They can take this to their users, their existing user base, and leverage that.
Elon Musk, do you know much about what he's done to Twitter?
He's pretty much messed up the whole Twitter culture. Dude, and everybody hates him.
Being verified used to matter. I'm verified. I pay $7 a month for it. Here's why. Because you can post videos up to 5 hours long. So if I have a 5-minute clip of my podcast, I don't need to cut it down to 2 minutes and 20 seconds. That's it. That's all.
It's definitely not worth it. And Instagram is kind of adopting the same thing. It's really an L. So social media
they
has
have
went
this
down.
Annoying thing, though, when you pay to be verified, because I've done it. You have to get their approval on the profile picture before you're like, so you sign up and they go, use this profile picture. And then you get the blue check mark. You know what happens? Let's say you go out to the club with your boys and you take a fire picture at Eborn. You look amazing. You got to wait for them to approve of it being your picture. I went, not worth it.
You know, now that we're talking about this, where's Tom? MySpace, Tom, where are you? Why are you not in the ring with everybody in the Coliseum? This might as well be a whole Royal Rumble.
The number of users on Instagram worldwide, 2 billion.
Wow.
Compared to some 300 million on Twitter. And buzz is building on social media.
This is what it's going to look like. It's really cool because you can actually look.
All right. I don't care anymore. Also, that's a visual. 856-49-HOPPY. That's 856-494-6773. You can tweet at me at Ryan Hoppy Radio, and you can always email me, ryanhoppyradio@gmail.com. Now, if you're saying, Ryan, why do you think Elon Musk ruined Twitter? This next headline right here, I swear to God, he might be an idiot. No. He'll never be a Zuckerberg or a Jeff Bezos because they built it from the beginning. He just bought it and came up with this riveting idea. Because when I think about using social media, bro, I'm thinking about, don't you think, like, have you seen the movie that's on Netflix about social media? The one that told you that you were addicted to it?
I've seen a couple episodes.
The Social Experiment.
Yeah, I saw a couple.
The whole idea to be on social media is to be on it all day.
Yeah, because they're trying to sell you something 24/7.
Twitter is giving you a limit of what you can view. If that app is not already dead, I get he's trying to make money, but literally Elon Musk might be the Spectrum thing. This might be the dumbest idea ever. I already don't like Twitter, and then you do this.
If you were scrolling Twitter yesterday and you got a message that said rate limit exceeded, you weren't alone, and that was on purpose.
Then I'm not going to go on Twitter. Oh, no, I can't go on Twitter. The worst one of them all. If that's not the dumbest idea I've ever heard of anything, and I'm not just being serious for the show, that literally might be the dumbest idea. To limit people of what they can see, then they're not going to go on your fucking app that already sucks.
Yeah, that's a big L for him. Imagine you taking a trip, an 8-hour trip, 10-hour trip. You like Twitter. What are you going to do?
And if you're verified, there's a limit as well. So literally, if you were to pay and you could see it all, I wouldn't think that's cool, but that would make sense. But he's limiting it if you pay. Because I pay $8 a month because of the different benefits I get from it. It's the only app that you get actual benefits from being verified. I know you're going to go, oh, you're paying to be verified. I don't care about your opinion. But literally, I get a viewing limit. Does he want everybody to go to IG and Facebook? He might be an idiot.
Twitter users spent Saturday reporting problems on the site after owner Elon Musk said he had implemented new temporary restrictions on how many tweets users can view. First, Musk announced that everyone would need a Twitter account to view any tweets, and then that verified accounts could read a max of 6,000 posts per day and a limit of just 600 posts for unverified accounts. Throughout the day, he increased those limits multiple times, ultimately reaching 10,000 and 1,000 respectively. He said the limit.
You know what should happen next? He should buy Spotify and just go, you know what? Sorry, you can only listen to 500 songs today.
Happy hour. Happy hour.
Now, I'm about to do the world premiere of Pharaoh's music. While I load this, tell me about it and what you want people to know about your music.
Okay, so this song is called Long Island. It's with my brother and a super talented artist, Slick Red. This music, this song kind of brings you into an island. He said it kind of reminded him of a Long Island, but I kind of see it more as a tropical. So this is Hoppy Radio, and this is Long Island.
She wanna run with the money. She wanna dance to the money. Just run to the money. To the money, just ran to the money. Yeah, shot and ran to the money. Shot and ran to the money. Dance to the money. To the money, just run to the money. To the money, just ran to the money. Yeah, shot and ran to the money. Shot and ran to the money. Got me touching like a doctor, but I ain't feel. The instrumental got me cooking with the damn grill. Let me slide it in slow, baby, stay still. Close your eyes, warm my heart, I just felt chills. I make songs for the lovers who hold hands still. I got love for my brothers in the damn field. Shoot a nigga in his head, that's a damn kill.
Look, Wangwan. She say I'm a bad man. I keep a big gun for the nigga run down. Tryna put it in a tum tum. Bad bitch, give me pum pum. I'm a bad man, bad man, bad man. Can't say these hoes, no, I'm not bad man. Got all the drugs, call me the trap man. And a nigga so hot like beach hot sun.
Cut my haters with them big ass guns. If you shoot it, keep a big ass drum. Mix the honey with some clean white rum. Slow it down, you gon' make me come. Fuck me slower like the beat got drums. Leave that nigga, he a weak ass bum.
Damn, Vero, where'd you find this at?
And play with me, yeah, I keep a K with me. She wanna lay down, chill, she wanna stay with me. I'm a shooter, so she say she feeling safe with me. And she the reason why these niggas always hate on me. I'm a bad man, I'm a real bad man.
Baby, come out.
Can't save the hoes, I'm not bad man, yeah.
Dance to the money, till the money just run to the money. Till the money just ran to the money, yeah. Shot and ran to the money, shot and ran to the money. Dance to the money, till the money just run to the money. Till the money just ran to the money, yeah. Shot and ran to the money, shot and ran to the money. Dance to the money, till the money just run to the money. Till the money just ran to the money, yeah. Shot and ran to the money, shot and ran to the money.
Pharaoh, good job, brah. Where the hell can people find all your work?
Listen, right now I have not uploaded anything and people are pissed at me.
You gotta upload it. At least go to SoundCloud, bro.
Yeah, at least gotta do SoundCloud. I don't know what's been going on, but...
What are you doing?
I wish I could show everybody the catalog. It's looking so fire, and I wish it was getting the...
You know what? Maybe that's a better sign. Maybe by, like, Christmas... You should make a Christmas rap song and then release a whole album of all of it or something.
That'd be amazing.
You're welcome.
We got live
from man, transitions aren't always perfect. What'd you say?
We actually might release it on Hobby Radio.
Hell yeah.
Why not?
Release it on my 30th birthday. Midlife crisis. Here we go.
He never holds back and he speaks his mind. Welcome back to Hobby Hour.
Ladies and gentlemen, here it is, the most listened to radio show on the planet. Even the other stations are tuned in too.
Oh, yes. 856-49-HOPPY. It's 856-494-6773. You can tweet at me at Ryan Hoppy Radio. You can always email me, ryanhoppyradio@gmail.com. If you ever hear me talk really slow when I'm introducing something, it's because I'm loading something.
Whoa! Hoppy Hot Topic!
Logan Paul is engaged.
Logan Paul and Nina Agdal are engaged.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
The Daily Mail was first to report the YouTube star proposed to his now fiance while on a vacay in Lake Como, Italy.
I love how he's drinking like protein or some energy drink water. I bet he was like, he got on his knees and like, yo, babe, you give the best blowjobs of all time. Can I marry you?
He's definitely that type of vibe. And I see he's holding a Prime.
Yeah, what is Prime?
Prime, I think, is his company.
Hell yeah. I just got married. Let's promote something, which I would do too.
Of course, always.
Como, Italy. 2 months after the couple celebrated their 1 year anniversary.
And I think that means everything.
In an Instagram tribute for the milestone, Logan reflected, one very special year with my Danish queen.
Okay. We're in 2023. I got to think about how to word this. She's good looking. She's beautiful. She seems like wifey material, and maybe that's what he wants because she's not like a babe. You know what I'm saying? Like, she's beautiful. Don't get me wrong, but he could definitely do better. But maybe true love, and he doesn't need to do better.
I mean, that's kind of, I don't know. I feel like the real wifey type women right now are the ones that aren't, you know what I'm saying, with the BBLs, the big boobs, the big lips, and the big butts. Like, it's just kind of the truth, you know? So, like, you got to picture yourself and where you want to be.
You know what I realized recently?
What?
So I'm talking to this girl right now. No one's ever going to know what she looks like. I'm never going to post a picture. Because whenever you go through breakups, then everyone asks, where's that person at? No one's going to ever know. There's no reason. There's no reason to let people know anymore.
Exactly. It's dead and gone.
Recalling the first time they met, Mina said, quote, it instantly felt like I had known him for years.
Literally, he's been on TV for 15. Of course you'd known him. It's like if I were to meet Regis Philbin and be like, well, he's dead. That's a weird example. Pat Sajak, I feel like I've known you. You spun a wheel.
If a girl's witty, she can make a joke that can make me laugh, I'm in. I'm sold.
She must be funny then. You know, oh my God, this is going to be a little raunchy. You know when you know, even if you end up breaking up with the person, in the prime of any relationship that's long-term, you could be married for 50 years, you could be dating for 2 years. You know when you know you're in a relationship or that it's not just a hookup? It's when you can make jokes during sex. Like, whenever I've been in a relationship, and let's say oral pleasures are going on, you have like a play-by-play commentary or you have like a certain inside joke. Like in the past, a lot of girls laugh because I have a Chicago accent and I say things very Chicago during sex. Like with my ex, I was like, can I lick the boobies? So then it was like, can I lick the boobies? And even with this girl I'm seeing now, I say things very Chicago. And that's like when you know that you're kind of like in a relationship is when you're able to laugh during it.
Well, pause. What did they even say? What did they even say when you said, can I lick the boobies?
It was a laughter thing. I'll never forget. I was, and I asked, and the ex was like, huh? I was like, come on now.
So everybody was shocked.
Everybody was, including my cat that was watching us.
The Sports Illustrated swimsuit model has seen her fair share of high-profile romances.
Yeah, because she has no talent and she needs clout.
Nina's previously been linked to Leonardo DiCaprio and Adam Levine.
Hell yeah, Logan Paul's Eskimo brothers with the other sluts of Hollywood. Hell yeah. I'm surprised she hasn't banged John Mayer with that list.
Meanwhile, Logan was coming off a relationship with Josie Canseco.
Oh yeah, dating Jose Canseco's daughter. No. That might be the most frightening thing of all time. To literally date Jose Canseco's daughter, that means you have to deal with Jose Canseco. Do you know much about Jose Canseco?
I really don't. Can you give me
He was a baseball player that cheated in the game and is very roided up and tweets very manic things. So it would be like having a crazy father-in-law that played baseball and cheated.
Yeah, we don't want those.
Yeah, you don't want that at all. You don't want to have to deal because you know what's funny? What type of girl do you attract? Because any girl I've ever dated or hooked up with, every single one, I've swung whatever the amount of girls I've hooked up with and dated. I've swung 1,000. I've gone perfect from the free throw line. What do you think are the two qualities that every girl that I've dated has?
I think, one, that we're good at sex.
Well, yeah, but that's to date me, you got to be good at that.
All right, so that's a given. Okay, so I'm still at square one. Let me see.
Think about it. I'm a nice guy. I don't cheat.
They're like video games.
First one.
Okay. Second one, they're like food.
No. First example.
What's the first example?
Daddy issues.
Oh, no. Those are the worst.
All of them.
Those are the emotional wrecks.
All of them. I have never dated a girl that's been like, you know what? Me and my dad are tight. We're so good. And I love my dad. And we just are so close. I've had some that are okay fathers and some that were literally horrendous fathers. But I don't know what that says about me. I am always attracting girls that don't get along with their fathers.
You are a father figure.
That's the way I'll be daddy is when I'm banging. I'm not actually a daddy. Second quality. What do you think the second quality is?
This
is more sexual. This is more about the person. What do you think is the second thing that all three of my alleged girlfriends? Because I'm kind of spilling a little bit of info. But when you have people in the past that have spilled all the info, I don't really give a fuck. What do you think is the second quality that I attract in a female?
Well, judging by the first quality, I'm going to vote with delusional.
Yeah, that too. You know what it is, though? And I'm being serious when I say this. I'm not saying this because I'm trying to be edgy. I'm trying to be wild. I'm trying to be nuts. No. You know what it is?
What is it?
Bisexual.
Happy hour. Happy hour.
Struggle is infinite, maybe it never ends. Survival time calls for desperate measurements. Your days are numbered and your money's always thin. Yeah. The cycle continues. Everyday new issues trying to get through, rent due. Bills due, this breakthrough gets mental. Stress the number one killer, blood pressure on 1,000. The scene gets realer, envy surrounds the brain pounding. Roller coaster ride, seems the end has begun. Underclass is day one, so the ball keeps bouncing. Every meal served, another die starving. The hunted becomes the hunter, now the hunger enlarges. This is the wild, where the love grows scarce. Die slow while the devil growls in laughter. Misery ever after, we love the disaster. Engulfed in violence, no sleep when the opposition lives in the shadows. It's a battle, life or death, and evil what we up against. More crime, more eyes to view the decadence. The struggle is infinite, maybe it never ends. Survival time calls for desperate measurements. Your days are numbered and your money's always spent.
No one has ever suffered the way I've suffered. No, my God. You realize that your suffering does not isolate you. That your suffering is your bridge. That many people have suffered before you. Many people are suffering around you. And always will.
Every day, every night, it's a struggle. A tussle with the world full of customers to hustle. Gotta have hands and muscle, we're made of featherweight. Life detonates while we celebrate. Keeping sanity, using nature for meditation. Positive reinforcing on the whole population. Living on the states, watching chaos commence. Easy way to make a dollar, but it never makes sense. Close my eyes to imagine a world with no stress. Not realizing the circumstances made me feel blessed. In the pursuit of happiness, we looking for a way into heaven.
Yeah, too bad it's not real. The afterlife, no. Not my thing.
Please don't be offended. He's sorry in advance.
Call Hoppy now. 856-49-HOPPY.
Ladies and gentlemen, here it is. The most listened to radio show on the planet. Even the other stations are tuned in too.
Oh, yes. 856-49-HOPPY. That's 856-494-6773. You can tweet at me at Ryan Hoppy Radio. You can always email me. All right, enough of this. RyanHoppyRadio@gmail.com.
Kevin Costner split. What does this contentious divorce battle have to do with his exit from Yellowstone?
I'm not going to lose this one.
It all comes down to money, of course. Kevin claims he simply can't afford Christine's $248,000 a month child support request.
Excuse me, did you hear about this?
Those numbers got me lost.
Kevin Costner's ex-wife that he's about to divorce? Wants $250,000 a month in child support.
How much is he making?
Well, we're about to find out because he's leaving that show. He's not making that.
Kevin Costner split. What does this contentious divorce battle have to do with his exit from Yellowstone?
I'm not going to lose this one.
It all comes down to money, of course. Kevin claims he simply can't afford Christine's $248,000 a month child support request now that he's leaving the show. Quote, I told Christine that I thought 2023 would be a difficult year financially if I was not working on Yellowstone. My estimated monthly cash flow will drop dramatically. Christine told me she understood.
Yeah, get a job. Find a hobby. Get a talent.
I don't see any other way. Burn it.
In May, Paramount officially announced Yellowstone will end with its fifth season. The extent of Costner's participation in the final episodes have yet to be determined. Co-creator Taylor Sheridan has promised fans John Dutton's exit will be treated with respect, despite their rumored rift.
Yeah, I love when like creators don't get along, but then in the end, the one that began the drama is like, oh yeah, we're good. Yeah, just, I'm not the problem. No. Sir, you are the problem. Do you watch anything that's of the Wild West theme? I find that to be the boringest thing ever. Oh, I want to watch a good Western. No, thank you.
No, I like more of like The Walking Dead.
I like the first season of Walking Dead, and then I got a little sick of it.
Taylor has actually told me that he knows how Yellowstone ends. Do you know?
No, I don't know how it ends.
Would you want to know?
Yeah, kind of.
You want to know?
Yeah. I'm going to end it if it doesn't end.
That's him saying, I hate this show, and I want this to end. All right. We're about to wrap up Happy Hour and end this show as well. But first, this next rapper I'm about to play, I didn't realize until recently how many artists I've come into contact with. This guy is super cool. His name is Lil Six, and he also works for a Kava and Kratom company, Vitamines. And we're going to be getting products and getting lit at my apartment on it. And we're also going to play some of his music as well, because he's a good dude, and I haven't met him yet. But everybody in the Kava and Kratom community is talking about Lil Six. And here is the world premiere for Happy Hour of Lil Six right here on Happy Hour.
Happy Hour. Happy Hour.
Lately, I've been pouring up too much lately. I've been sipping on, yeah. As of lately, I've been pouring up too much lately. I've been pouring up, yeah. Yeah, and how did they say that we friends, but they not gonna be here until the end, yeah. And I don't need anyone, friend, yeah. I just wanna go with a band, yeah. And how the fuck they gonna post all the girls, but they not gonna choose it. We know that they not gonna do shit. We know that they, yeah. As of lately, I've been pouring up too much lately. I've been sipping on too much lately, yeah, as of lately, I've been pouring up too much lately. I've been smoking on too much lately. I've been smoking way too much lately. My left lung just told me he hate me. My right lung just told me he hate me. My brain just told me that I'm crazy. My heart just told me to be patient. I know it hurts right now, but we gon' make it. Yeah. I know that it's gon' be amazing. Yeah, I know that we gonna go make it. Yeah, my only problem is I want every single girl in the world, want them now. I feel like it's Solomon, I want them all of me. I want them all in my motherfucking house. She said that she follow me, now she gon' swallow me. Yeah, she gon' swallow my dick in her mouth. She told me she love me, she crazy. I told her that I love her brazy. Yeah. As of lately, I've been pouring up too much lately. I've been sipping on too much lately. Yeah, as of lately, I've been pouring on too much lately. I've been smoking on too much lately. She told me she with me forever. I corrected her, told her, baby, you meant to say till. Until these feelings ain't real. Until there's nothing to feel. And I told my brother, you better watch who's around you, cause I seen them switch up for a bill. They switch up just for a little puss. They switch up just so they could feel some. They switch up just so they could feel some. So you better stay with the real ones, cause right now you not with the real ones. If I say kill some, then they go to kill some. If I got problem, I'm not gonna deal with it. I send my little brother, he'll deal with it. I send my little brother, he'll kill some. I send my little, yeah. Yeah, as of lately, I've been pouring up too much lately. I've been sipping on too much lately. I've been pouring up, yeah. As of lately, I've been pouring up too much lately. I've been pouring up, yeah. She told me she loved me, she crazy. I told her that I love her crazy.
Oh, yeah, like every NBA player should do as well. It is time to wrap this bitch up.
Ladies and gentlemen, here it is, the most listened to radio show on the planet. Even the other stations are tuned in, too.
Pharaoh.
Yo.
Where can people find your work?
Listen, make sure to check me out at YNG Pharaoh, and that's on Instagram. I'm not going to give you my government, so you're not going to find me on Facebook. But yeah, if you go on Twitter, I'm also YNG Pharaoh, and that's Pharaoh, P-H-A-R-O-H, and it says The Last Pharaoh.
Ah, man. I've promoted myself so much over the years that I'm so tired, I don't even feel like doing it. Just pretty much search up Ryan Hoppy, and you'll see things.
Happy Hour. Hoppy.
Happy Hour.